I'll be speaking on starting a new semester well and finishing strong. I'm Abigniola Adeboye, Foundry Level Students, Department of Civil Engineering at the University of Ilorin. Academic programs in the higher institutions are usually split into semester, which is a period of time usually specified by the school authority for the student to engage in academic activities such as lectures, project work, lab work, assignments, etc. To succeed as an undergraduate, you must pay attention to your academic performance for each semester, and a critical assessment of growth must be assessed. Starting a new semester, I believe, well, might seem impossible with the daunting tasks and the new methods of teaching that might be encountered by students, but I believe that with the following things I will discuss now, you can easily get through the startup way. So sit down and enjoy the video. The first thing I'll talk about is the mindset. It's very important that you develop a positive mindset even as students in the institution. Individuals, we have peculiarities, we have so many challenges that we face in our everyday life, but one thing is we must maintain a positive mindset. You must have a mindset for growth, because you can't really grow and develop academically if you don't have a mindset for growth. I see so many students on campus, they don't have any goal, they don't have any aspiration, and so many of them are not even motivated. When you ask them, "Hey, why you study this particular course?" They are not motivated at all. You need to look out for those things that you didn't do well in the previous semester, and you have to work out on how you can change the situation. Look out for those things you did well through, and how you can improve them. You can't continue to do the same thing and expect different results. One of my teachers really tell me then, "No, it's not possible. That's not possible." Goal setting is key, and you must ensure that your goal is smart. So for each semester, you must have a set goal. Your goal must be smart. That is, it must be specific, it must be measurable, it must be achievable, it must be realistic and time-bound. You must be able to measure it with time. And let's assume your goal is to have not less than 4.5 CGPA for a particular semester. Once you have set the goal, then another thing is you must work towards achieving the goal. The next thing I'll talk about is reflection. You have to reflect on what you have done in the past. You have to study yourself, your performance in the past semesters. This is a very important aspect of improving your academic performance. I hear a lot of academic stories. So many people started with bad grades, be like a CGPA of 2.3.4 thereabouts. But along the way, they were able to reflect on their past performances, and they work on improving their academic performance. And on the long run, they were able to graduate with a good CGPA. Many of them graduated with a first class, even having started the academies in under level with a third class. Now you have to critically assess your activities and performances for the previous semester, because it will help you to identify your strengths and your weaknesses. So when you identify your strengths, you improve on them. Then when you identify your weaknesses, you also work on them as well. Now the next thing I'll talk about is preparation. You have to prepare, you have to plan, you have to prepare, you have to plan, you have to prepare. Adequate preparation prevents poor performance. You must prepare very well for the new semester. You must make sure you have met with students in a high level studying your course, most preferably a scholar from the department. Let's assume you are a student, 200 level student of the Department of Civil Engineering. You have students in 300 level that have done, they've done those courses. You can meet them, you can ask them questions about the courses. I know things change, but when you ask them questions, you get a lot of information from them. It will help you to learn from the experiences. And I personally, I prefer to speak through as many students as possible. I'll compare and contrast their responses. I'll ask questions because I know it will help me to have a good knowledge of what to expect from each courses I'm to offer for this semester. So you can also do the same. Get the necessary materials and academic tools that will boost the academic performance for the semester. You have to work and pray. That's very important. You have to work and pray. Very important. Yes, you have learned from the experience of senior students. You already know what the semester demands from you. A combination of both hard work and smart work is key to achieving academic success in a new semester. You must pray like you never work and work like you never pray. Yes, that's very valid. The next thing I'll talk about is being optimistic and resilient. You have to be positive. I said it when I started the video, a positive mindset. Yes, you just have to be optimistic. It will happen at times that you have set a goal of having an A in a particular course, but you find out along the way that it might not seem possible because the course is a tough one. Yes, it happens at times. Sincerely, you just have to be positive. You just have to be resilient. That's the only way. That's the only way you can get to write. You just have to be positive. Many students have enough comprehensive knowledge, but they just apply few of that knowledge. So I've taken you through some few tips on how you can start a new semester well and how you can finish it strong. You have to know that it's not just what you know that really matters, but what you apply, the application of your knowledge. You usually notice a great academic development, a great change in your academic development, and that will help you to achieve academic excellence if you critically follow the steps that have been discussed